Well, the story of how African slaves got to the Caribbean paradoxically begins in Britain, with Britain's expansion as a commercial power in the 17th and 18th centuries. And the triangle of trade was really took goods from Britain to exchange for slaves on the West African coast. And the slaves were then herded into ships and transported across the Atlantic in that terrible middle passage, sold into slavery in the Americas. And then the third leg of that trade brought the product of slave labor in the Americas, rum and tobacco and molasses and cotton, back to British cities like Bristol and Liverpool and so on.
And ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit, but my hand was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever had, redemption songs, redemption songs, redemption songs, these songs of freedom. Songs of freedom.
After the English drove out the Spaniards, the Maroons, they were the slaves of the Spaniards, and they went into the bushes. And from that time, they started to demonstrate their skill regarding the knowledge of the woods and also survival. And Nanny, the great chieftainess, the greatest of all our leaders, she made her fortress up on the Blue Mountains. And she clothed her soldiers in the leaves and branches of trees. And this thing was done so realistically that when the British came, these trees would move, encircling the British army. The end result was that the Maroons were completely victorious. In fact, the English themselves, the British, approached the Maroons and begged for peace. It was a wise thing, of course, because the island became a better place to live in.
Well, the word Maroons really comes from a Spanish word, cimarron, meaning a runaway slave. And marinage, the communities of runaway slaves, was really common throughout all slave society. And these Maroon communities provided the best conditions for the survival of traditional African customs and practices in the Caribbean.
Because we are a set of people who like to express ourselves in dancing, then we must have the music in order to dance. Music plays such a part that it is an all-pervading part, and I think that helps to make one a little stronger than he would have been otherwise. Thank you. his customs and so forth were brought directly from Africa and were preserved. In the area that is now Ghana, that time it was the Gold Coast. You see, the majority of our forefathers came from that section of Africa, the Ashantis. Suppose we are having a celebration. See, it is joy, it is merriment, and we sing those songs and we are happy and we try to make others happy too. And then to think of the spirits and to get in touch with them, the music had to be used.
Parts for nearly 500 years. After 1807, a truly indigenous form developed or got a chance to develop. But up to that time, there were waves of new African migrations of slaves into the territory. By the 19th century, the Europeans were going further down the African coast. And many of the slavers which were caught in the high seas had slaves who were coming from what we now know as the Congo. Some of these people came to Jamaica after 1838 as indentured laborers. And one tradition has it that the Kumina religious cult came in at that time, and hence the recency and the durability of the deep Africanity, if you like, of that particular ritual. Thank you.
mother were born in St. Thomas here, and my father is from St. Elizabeth. So I am from an African and a Maroon tribe. We do the Kumina in helping people when they are sick, that's one. And we do the Kumina as a pleasure at Christmas time, August, and even at Easter time.
We call a Kumina ceremony to invoke the gods for a court case, for blessing in marriage, a number of things, in entombing and whatever. And again, there's a sacrifice, which are good sort of religious practices, you know. We have our sacrifices in Christianity as well. And of course, spirit possession.
Sometimes when we play Kumina, we are tombing. Okay? Someone may be sick and they call for a Kumina, then you play the Kumina. We play Kumina that at when sometimes when people die, that we play Kumina.
The black and white Kumina is when you have anybody dead and making a prayer for them. Okay, you use the black and white and candle. That's the time you kill the goat.
European presence in the Caribbean and the Americas is a Spanish one, and consequently a Catholic one. It's Catholic Spain that are the first conquistadores of the Americas. and the British slavers and colonizers really come in on the Spanish coattails. I mean, of course, in places like Jamaica, which we now think of as British, were originally Spanish, and the Spanish influence, Spanish Catholic influence, one should say, is still very predominant in islands like Cuba and Puerto Rico, and of course, what we now call the Dominican Republic.
Llegaron, todas sus manifestaciones religiosas les fueron prohibidas. Pero así como ellos lo fueron cristianizando, ellos comenzaron a tocar en las fiestas religiosas católicas y lo que tocaban eran sus motivos religiosos africanos que ellos vestían con la religión católica porque decían que eran adorando a los santos y fueron buscando la equivalencia de sus dioses con los santos católicos. Y así, su dios de la guerra, su dios del hierro, le pusieron un nombre católico de un santo. Y así nació el sincretismo religioso, que es hoy la parte vital de la religiosidad popular dominicana.
A syncretic culture is really neither the one thing nor the other. It's neither European any longer, nor African, because it's fusing on a third place, in a third area, in the Caribbean, and it's fusing in a slave colony. And so the result is something which owes a great deal to European and African past, but is neither one thing nor the other. It's the fusion and formation of a third distinctive culture, a syncretic culture.
País fue el único que ganó su independencia de Haití y no de España. Los primeros 20 años de la República lo pasamos guerreando con intentos de invasión y así nació una actitud hostil contra Haití acerca del mal que hacen los haitianos. Ellos trajeron el vudú, ellos trajeron, comen niños, hacen todas las cosas malas, las hacen los haitianos. Y siempre han tratado de dividir nuestros pueblos. Y en la cédula personal de identidad nunca dice una persona que es negra, sino indio oscuro, indio lavado, indio ligero, etc. esa no es la realidad, pero eso es lo que nos han enseñado. Y cada vez que presentamos algo como de origen haitiano, dicen no, eso lo de origen africano, dicen no, eso lo trajeron los haitianos y no quieren saber de nada negro en nuestra cultura, porque para el dominicano común, nosotros somos un pueblo blanco de ojos azules.
Tengo una mala, no la voy a comprar, yo voy de una negra, que la llama cam.
Yo soy el patrón de Guarabano, yo soy el patrón de Guarabano. Muchos ponen vela, otros ponen flores, muchos ponen vela, otros ponen flores. Antonio rogando por los pecadores, Antonio rogando por los pecadores.
Y así vendieron esclavos vara por todo el Caribe, y por eso hoy hay merengues en Curazao, Venezuela, Colombia, Panamá, Cuba, Puerto Rico y Santo Domingo. Y así mezclamos un nombre y un ritmo, porque el ritmo es totalmente africano, con una forma melódica europea.
Dice San Antonio, aquí mamo yo. Dice San Antonio, aquí mamo yo. Yo soy el patrón de Guarabano. Yo soy el patrón de Guarabano. Muchos ponen velas, otros ponen flores. Muchos ponen velas, otros ponen flores. Antonio rogando por los pecadores. Antonio rogando por los pecadores.
Mis tía un sancocho de muchas cosas diferentes. Mezcla elementos precristianos con música del siglo XII de Inglaterra, música africana, instrumentos africanos, pero la cuerda dorsal del momis es el play, como le llaman ustedes, que se conserva más o menos pura, con los caracteres principales de Rey Jorge, el Caballero Turco, Sasanás y otros cuantos personajes que realmente se han conservado a pesar de todas las evoluciones y de todas las influencias que ha tenido que soportar el momis en nuestro país.
Good, my friends and neighbors here. We are quite glad to meet you here. For Christmas come but once a year, and when it come it bring good cheer. May luck to turn your milk in pail, when each wind blows over chassis field, when our mommy's time come round, hurrah!
Comenzaron a venir los inmigrantes ingleses de las islas, desde mediados del siglo pasado, cuando comenzó la industria azucarera en nuestro país. La inmigración llegaron a constituir una subcultura, la subcultura cocola, como les llamamos, que ha mantenido vigente los elementos principales de ellos hasta el día de hoy.
I'm a British. Pay the immigration every year. I'm a British. So anytime I want to leave the country, nobody stop me.
Why is it important to be a British?
Because that's my flag. I love my flag until when I go to the grave. I'm not supposed to sell my British flag. No nation. That's my flag, British flag.
You spoke the English language when you came here?
Yes, yeah, to my English people. But you know, the language in the dam is Spanish. But when I met with my English people, I speak English. You understand? This country have a, this town here, many years back, it have plenty more English people. But plenty of them gone away and plenty die out. You understand?
I am the king of Egypt. Jove so plainly disappear. I come to seek my son, my only son and heir. But he's dead, and that's the worst of it. Whom did I fail? And whom did I fail? Yes, yes, my leader, I will obey. But with my sword, I hope to win the day. With my sword and gun, I hope to win the day. So stand forth, where St. Judge, her Christian and body fearful.
I don't want just.
Turkish knife. Why am the Turkish knife? Just from the Turkish land to fight. I will now take St. David from my foe. And made him kneel before I go. Yes, yes, my league I will obey. For with my sword, I hope to win the day. With my sword and shield, I hope to win the day. Roger.
Carnival is found all over the place, wherever you find a Catholic tradition, and it's really the celebrations at Easter up to Shrove Tuesday, which precede the long period of fasting and Lent. But I think carnival has a deeper meaning. Wherever you find it, it always includes the idea of a reversal. That's to say, of the time when the oppressed or the poor who don't normally celebrate or are not normally licensed to enjoy and express themselves have a moment when they're permitted to do so, and their masters stand aside and, as it were, watch the slaves take over for a moment. And in fact, in Jamaica, the Jonkanoo processions, which occur at Christmas time, are really Jamaican versions of carnival.
Bye. notice that in Latin America, they have this Jonkanoo. And we, as children, we call it Jonkanoo. And to me, that similarity is not likely to be just coincidental. Also, the hobby horse is part of Jonkanoo. And the hobby horse, as you know, is something that's in Indian. We find it in Yugoslavia. We find it in Basque country. And I'm sure there are a lot of other places. So Jonkanoo really is quite a potpourri.
Well, we dance, our different performance. Say the queen dance softly. You are the devil, Satan, you know, just go out. You are the wild Indian, just run in the bush and bawl out, you know. Like that, they say, woo, 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 you know. And then dance around. You have the acid, you have the coil. When they don't get the Jonkanoo, they just like somebody out there, you know, getting mad. They would like to see it every year. So keep them amusing. Or if it's not the Jonkanoo, they don't know that it's Christmas. See? We know that Christmas is tomorrow. And if the Jonkanoo don't come out, you don't see no liveliness. You don't see no crowd.
To me is a whole time thing, you know. You heard of it that it come from some country over foreign, you know, Jonkanoo. But in first days that gone past, Jonkanoo never recognized like now. They walk along the street and play drum and knock on people, ask, stone them and call them dirty Jonkanoo. But now what is hide from the wise and prove them revealed to babe and suckling. The Jonkanoo come up to a mark now that he come after you like a person in the church, you know. It's very wonderful. Because they have to send us telegram now when they want us and bring us to wherever they want and give us the best treatment, and nobody can molest us because we are guarded by police and soldiers on the ground now. So it's a very good thing. I start with the pipe sometimes in 1928, 6th of March, and I start with the pipe around in 1932. My mother died when I was 4 years old, and a good pipe man, I was bawling to go with her. I never realized who was dead. And the man gave me the pipe named Harold Leach from Jack's River, St. Mary. He said, blow, your mother soon come. So when I take the pipe, I couldn't turn a tune on, just getting a sound in the pipe and forget to cry for my mother until she's buried off, and always have the pipe all day, blowing, 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 so till I could be able to turn a tune. Playing the music, you know. I always love to play a tune that the girls them can hear and look at it. If the tune suit them, you know, they always draw attention towards the Jonkanoo bands and said, he can play the pipe very well because I can play a tune that says to them, said, this tune, the name of this tune is where your wheel and turn, you know. Belly pan tambourine, you know.
Can you sing that song?
Yeah. Where you want wheel and turn me? Where you want wheel and turn me? You want me to fall down? Lick me belly pan tambourine. Where you want wheel and turn me? Where you want wheel and turn me? You want me to fall down? Lick me belly pan tambourine.
So on my way to school, they would always be digging up the streets of Kingston. It seemed to me when I was a child, and they were singing these digging songs, you know. Judy drowned, Judy drowned, why, oh, Judy drowned. And they come down to it's line on chorus, you know, and they always have a singer man who raises the tune. You know, they had to pay a man to sing separately, you know. The government in those days, when they were digging the streets, and the singer man would raise the tune, man, and he says, Judy drowned, Judy drowned, everybody come down. Why, oh, Judy drowned, Judy drowned, Judy drowned, why, oh, Judy drowned, Judy no drowned, Judy in a bed, Judy body ball, oh, Judy drowned, Judy no dead, but Judy drowned, why, oh, Judy drowned. And this, you know, so you would listen to this, oh boy. And then one of the first ones that I used to hear, and this was very popular, was Chichibod. Up to today, Chichibod is my favorite Jamaican folk song. And when I go on the stage on, I say, and now I'm going to end by singing my favorite, and everybody said, Chichibod! And that is, Chichibod means a flock of birds. And the singer man calls out the names of the birds, and the diggers, or the chorus, they say, some of them are holler, some are bawl. Some are hollering and some are bawling. So this singer man says, ah, Chichibada, some of them are holla, some are ball. Chichibada, some of them are holla, some are ball. Some are come long, some of them are holla, some are ball. Some are blue foot, some of them are holla, some are ball. Ting, ting, some of them are holla, some are ball. Ching, ching, some of them are holla, some are ball, you know. Some are chick man chick and all the different birds, you know. And I used to love this, you know. Some of them are holla, some are ball. And then at the end he says, some of them, when he's going to, at the end, you know, he generally ends with Jonkanoo, you know, the crow. Some are Jonkanoo, some of them are holla, some are ball.
This fourth beat, to me, is very often accented. You get, Hilangali rido, Hilangali. And the same thing happens in Mento. We get so on. And you know, any Mento you think, you'll get that. I'm sure it has some significance. We haven't found out what it is yet.
Remember when I was doing all my research into Jamaican folklore, and I said to one old gentleman I'm talking to, you know, and I said to him, what you call all the songs? He says, every Jamaica folk song is a mento. Every Jamaica folk song is a mento. We sing mento. So I say, where we get the mento from? He said, we grow it. Thank you. I started with the language, and then the language led you on to the proverbs, the riddles, the stories, the songs. It was not just that people were talking like this because they couldn't do better. It was that they were creating a thing for themselves, something that was better for their personality, you know, to express themselves in a way. And it was a whole creative process.
I love coffee, I love tea. I love the boy and the boy loves me. I love coffee, I love tea. I love the boy and the boy loves me.
If you go to school and you're taught to read and write in one language, and but the language is not the language that you talk normally or you talk at school. But I should really say before that, you know, because parents are always saying, don't say that, you know, talk right, you know, talk, why don't talk correct? And this sort of thing. And they're always sort of telling you that the bad language, you know, this was bad. But you never paid much attention because they were talking, sometimes when they were telling you it was a bad language, they were talking in the same language to you, you know.
But on the Manuel Road, the land wide, he got rock, rock, stone.
No pride, Galam boy, remember that play with that play, Galam boy, you know, and they pass the stones and you have to pass them fast. And you finger mash, not cry. You must not, you know, cry if your fingers get mashed. Remember that play with that play? We are playing, we're only playing, you know.
Morning, buddy.
Good morning, Peter. Then I ooh,
then I
care.
Which I send us?
Then I saw.
Which I saw?
Then I buy.
Which I buy?
Buy a tea.
Which I see?
Then I go.
Which I go?
For a car.
Which I far?
For a mar.
Which I ma? Which a doodle?
Doodle flash.
Which a flash?
Bennett.
Which a Bennett?
Bennett.
To the one that play the young girl more. Then they call mama, then they call papa, then they call put them again, the girl move on. No, that is no
the rhythm of the language. You find the same rhythm in the Mento songs. You find the same rhythm in the Poco songs, in the revival, in the reggae. You will find that the same rhythm of the spoken, the Jamaican language, you know?
And me brother Dilly Dally, he say we gone down the alley. Don't we smoke up the collie. Don't in the kingdom of the heaven, happy ghetto, I would tell you. Don't in the kingdom of the heaven, happy ghetto, I would tell you. I say the cats were superstars.
One of the first things that ordinary Jamaicans could do was to either read the Bible or know about certain Bible stories. Now, it's these biblical rhythms, I think, that have really deeply penetrated the vernacular language. And you hear it in the reasoning and prophecy of reggae and reggae lyrics, but you hear it also in ordinary speech of people who, in their ordinary talk, will suddenly elevate their language and take in what is, in fact, a key passage from the St. James Bible.
So be wise, therefore, in peace and peace, chuckle, be far, good drop the turn. Turn, Lord God, to rock so far, I would fear, rejoice, and tremble. Sinai, the son, and let's see the anger. The first one was waved from the draught of the people, but the living. And so blessed be all, blessed be everyone in our say. And so blessed be all they that put their trust in the true and living God, the Rastafari. For this man shall be like the holy mountains of Zion that cannot be removed but abiding forever.
Well, I think reggae is a sort of essential Caribbean form because it's a hybrid form. Because you can hear the different influences in it. On the one hand, it comes from that movement, that moment in the 60s, when people discovered the sort of elemental rhythms of Jamaican music. But I think that was a moment really of essentially recapturing something deeply African about rhythmic forms in Jamaica.
Thank you.
On the other hand, reggae music and its harmonies and its voice production and so on owe a great deal to North American blues, to North American soul music, to gospel music. And both these two traditions fuse in the technology of the new music industry, which explodes in Jamaica in the 60s and 70s. And so it's really the product of Africa on top of America, on top of a modern 20th century musical technology. One of the most interesting things about Caribbean culture is that because its roots are lost somewhere in the past, it has constantly to kind of remake itself. And I think something of the same kind happens when substantial numbers of black people come to Britain and start to make their life there. You get a kind of Jamaican colony beginning to throb at the center of big British cities. And it's at that moment that they hear something in the music, new music coming out of Kingston, that is itself speaking of the oppression of people in Kingston, and they identified with that.
Hard, 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 hard. But it's my time now, I pay the piper, I call the tune. Said it's my time now, I pay the piper, I call the tune.
I think what we see is just simply the next turn of the creative screw, so to speak. I mean, what happened to music all along in the Caribbean has happened now to Caribbean people in Europe.
Never look back, never look back, never look back, never look back, never, 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 no, 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 no. Skip up, 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 up,